Boolean algebra and digital logic gates will be introduced in this video, and we will also discuss several theorems for modifying and simplifying Boolean algebra equations and hence digital logic gate circuits. So Boolean logic is based on three operations: inversion, conjunction, and disjunction. So inversion, or not the not operation, can be written like so, or it can be written is digital logic equations like this A bar, or if you need to type it, it can be easier to write A prime. All of these are different ways of implementing the inversion operation, not A. And this is implemented with the inverter. Like so. Conjunction. A anded with B. This is written using multiple syntaxes. So one possible way is to use the standard logic format A and B. You could also use a multiplication symbol, A anded with B. So it looks like standard multiplication. And this is implemented with the AND gate. A anded B, like so. Also, we have disjunction, which implements an OR operation. So A ORed with B. This can also be written as a plus operation, like so. The OR operation can be implemented in digital logic using the OR gate, which is written like this. So, inversion, conjunction, and disjunction, the not, the AND, and the OR gate can all be used to build digital logic. So there's a reason that we want to use plus and multiplication operators to represent this. The reason we wish to represent it this way is because of precedence. So we have not before and before or. Now remember, here the multiplication is used to represent an AND operation and the plus is used to represent an OR. By basic arithmetic, multiplication takes precedence over addition. That means the multiplication happens first. Therefore, the AND operation in our Boolean algebra is supposed to happen first. Also notice not needs to happen before the AND. This is precedence. So what does this lead us to? This means that we have some nice theorems that carry over from basic arithmetic. The commutative operation here. So A anded with B is the same as B anded with A. So it doesn't matter what the order of A and B is. You'll still get the same output. The same with A or B. It is the same as B or A. You can change the order. and the result does not change at all. Therefore, the commutative property still holds. The associative property allows us to change the order of which variables are anded first or ored first. So say we have a set of three variables here. A anded with B and then anded with C is the same as taking B anded with C first and then anding the result with A second. It doesn't matter which order the AND operations are executed. The result will still be the same. The same with the OR operator here. It doesn't matter if A or B happens before B or C. If at the end A is ORed with B or C first, or B is or C is ORed with A or B first, you'll still get the same result. Therefore, the associative property still carries over from arithmetic. Finally, we have the distributive property here. We have A anded with B or C. So we take this A and distribute it to B, A anded with B, and then we OR that result with A anded with C. A anded with B, ORed with A anded with C. So the Boolean logic theorems still hold that are carried over from arithmetic. Some other Boolean logic theorems that you should keep in mind. The identity operation here. Identity means that if we take any value and OR it with 0, then we will get the value back. So 0 ORed with 0, 0 ORed with 0 is equal to 0 here. 1 ORed with 0 is equal to 1 here. So 0 ANDed with 1 is equal to 0. 1 ANDed with 1 is equal to 1. This gives us the identity operation. So anytime you see a variable ORed with 0, then you can remove the ORing with 0. Anytime you see an AND with 1, you can remove the AND with 1. Next, we have the constant theorem. Any value that is ORed with 1 is going to equal 1. 0 OR 1 is 1. 1 ORed with 1 is 1. So the constant operation holds. Also, x ANDed with 0. If x is equal to 1 and you AND it with 0, then the result is 0. Also, if x is equal to 0 and it's ANDed with 0, the result is still going to be 0. So these are the constant theorems. Idempotency, or the idempotent law, gets a little trickier. Idempotency may not be immediately obvious to some viewers, but when you think about it, it's very straightforward when you go and plug in the numbers. So x ORed with x, let's let x equal to 0. Let's let x be equal to 0. So 0 ORed with 0 is equal to 0. So that property holds for x equal to 0. What about for x equal to 1? So 1 ORed with 1 is equal to 1. So idempotency holds for the OR gate. Let's try for the AND gate here. So if x is 0, 0 ORed with 0 or 0 anded with 0, excuse me, is going to be 0. Now let's try x equal to 1. 1 anded with 1 is equal to 1 again. So idempotency holds for both the AND gate and the OR gate. The complementary rule only appears in digital logic. It doesn't come from arithmetic because it uses an inversion operation. Notice the inversion here and here with the prime symbol. So let's try substituting some values to see if we can understand what's going on. So let's look at x anded with x prime first. So x equal to 0 right here. So x prime equals 1. 0 anded with 1 is equal to 0. Well, if x is equal to 1 now, right here, if x is equal to 1 now, then x prime is going to be equal to 0. Notice that regardless, if x is 1, then x prime is 0, or vice versa. So we are always anding with 0. Therefore, we always get a 0 here for the complementary theorem. Also, for the OR operation, if x is equal to 1 here, then x prime is equal to 0. If x is equal to 0, then x prime is equal to 1. We are always ORing with a value 1. 0 ORed with 0 ORed with 1. 0 ORed with 1, or 1 ORed with 0. Because we always OR with 1, we will always get 1. So we'll come to De Morgan's Law. De Morgan's Law is a bit interesting, and it's one that you will probably use quite a bit. This gives us the ability to distribute this prime symbol right here. X anded with y prime, we can distribute the prime to x and y like so, if and only if we exchange AND for OR and exchange OR for AND. So also, the De Morgan's Law has another form using the OR gate. So x OR y quantity inverted. This is the same as distributing this prime symbol here. And we get x prime and y prime, like so. When we distribute the prime symbol, then we have to convert AND to OR. Alternatively, we convert OR to AND. Finally, we have the involution property here. So what is happening here? It's a double inversion, inverting twice. So if we have 1 inverted a second time, this is equal to, well, let's just do this operation, that is 1 prime, that's 0, and then that's inverted again, that's going to be equal to 1. So we do a double inversion, 1 goes to 0 goes to 1. If we have a double inversion with 0, 0 goes to 1, goes to 0. So our final value is 0 if we start with 0. It is 1 if we start with 1. Therefore, x prime prime is equal to x. Some other simplification theorems that you may run across that you can use when reducing the size of your Boolean algebra equations. X and y, ORed with x and y prime is equal to x. How do we get this? Well, you can factor out the x using the distributive property. So x equals y or y prime. And now we have the property here. Y or y prime is equal to 1. So x ended with 1. And now we use the identity theorem. Here, x ended with 1 is equal to x, and we see that we have this right here. You can also use for x or y, ended with x or y prime, to verify that it's equal to x. How do we go through and do this? You could take a minute here to try it yourself. Hint, try using the distributive property again. Okay, let's go through it. We'll look at here. X ended with x. X ended with y prime. Y ended with x. Y ended with y prime. So let's write these all out. X with x, ORed with x ended with y prime, ORed with y and x, ORed with y and y prime. Well, right off the bat, we see that y ended with y prime is equal to 0. So let's just cross that off. Also, we see that x ended with x here is a duplicate. So we can use it in potency. So we have x ORed with x, y prime, or x, y. Now take a look. What is this term? It is the same as this theorem here, except that we have the y prime and y exchanged. And we know that they are the same by the commutative law. So we can say that this is equal to x or x, because we need to carry this one over, and this is x, and this is x, so we have x or x. And by idempotency again, x ORed with x is equal to x. Proof for x ORed with x and y here, we can factor out the x variable. This gives us 1 or y, like so. And if we look closely, 1 ORed with y is an identity property, so we can say that, well, not an identity, that is actually a constant property. So we have a constant 1. X ended with 1, which is equal to x. Now, we have the next theorem. X ended with x or y, like this here. So let's use the distributive property to prove this. X ended with x, x ended with y. XX or XY. This is now, we see, idempotency applied here. X or xy. Whoops. X or xy. Now notice we can factor out an x from this term and an x from this term. So we get x ANDed with 1 or y, which equals x ANDed with 1, which equals x again. We came back to this theorem. The remaining two theorems which are available here, I'll leave them as an exercise to you to figure out. De Morgan's law is one law that we haven't touched on too closely yet, but one thing that you can think about with De Morgan's law is the inversion is pushed through a logic gate. And when we're working with De Morgan's laws and gates, we want to think about how we can do something called bubble pushing here. This is a term you may hear once in a while. What this means is you can take an inversion from the front side of a logic gate and push it to the back side. So the inversion goes from the output to the inputs. Notice that the logic functionality changes from AND to OR. If you change the inversion from being the on the output to the inputs. But the actual functionality doesn't change. So what we have here is a NAND gate. Here, and also a NAND gate here. We have two ways of implementing the NAND gate, like so. So let's recall, what is De Morgan's law? Let's write this in terms of A and B, variables A and B this time. So A ANDed with B, like so, is equal to A prime or B prime. Either of these represent a NAND operation. On this side, we have a NOR operation. An inversion on the output can be pushed to the inputs, like so. And while the gate symbol changes, it looks like it changes from an OR gate to an AND gate. Really, it's neither. It's a NOR gate. And the NOR operation can be written in Boolean algebra like so. Inversion. And it's possible to distribute this inversion symbol here, this prime symbol, to A and B. So we have A prime ANDed with B prime. This is the same as A or B prime. So how do we put it all together? We can use the Boolean algebra rules to simplify our logic circuits. So consider this circuit. We have an input A and an input B. Now if we think about it, we can write this as a truth table where we list all the possible input combinations of zeros and ones and look at the possible values of Y on the output. So let's do that. A, B, Y. 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, and 1. If A is equal to 0 here, and B is equal to 0, we have 0 inverted, we get a 1 here, and then we get a 1 here. If we have a 0 for B coming in, then we'll have a 0 here. So Y is equal to 1 ANDed with 0. 1 ANDed with 0 is 0. Let's think about A equal to 0, B equal to 1. So we'll have a 0 here at A and a B equal to 1. We'll use an inverter to change the 0 to a value 1. Let's look at 1 ORed with 1 using this OR gate. So 1 ORed with 1 should be 1, which goes to the input of the AND gate. We don't know what is at this node yet, so let's take a step back and look at B. 1. So 1 ANDed with 1 is going to equal 1. Again, 1 ANDed with 1 is going to equal 1. So A equals to 0, B equal to 1 implies that Y equals 1. So let's say A equals 1 and B equals 0. B equals B, of course. But let's say B equals 0 in this case. So if we invert, we get a 0 here. 0 ORed with 0 is 0. Uh-oh, so if we're ORing with 0, we don't care what's here. 0 ORed with anything is going to be 0. So let's just state that this is 0 here. And then A equals 1, B equals 1. Let's start with A equals 1 again, like right here. A equals 1, so we have a 0 here. 0 ORed with 0 is 0. 0 ANDed with anything is going to be 0, so our output is, we look closely, 0 here. So this is our truth table and shows us what all the possible input-output combinations are. Now, there's a way to simplify this, however, using the Boolean algebra theorems. So let's draw this out. So we're going to start with this inverter. A prime, and it goes to an OR gate, ORed with A prime, like so. This then goes to an AND gate here. So what are we ANDing there? We are feeding to that AND B, ANDed with B from this gate here. The output of that feeds to an AND gate here. So we have A prime ORed with A prime, ANDed with B prime, or ANDed with B and B. First of all, let's look at B and B. That is the idempotency rule, so we can immediately remove one of those B's. So A prime or A prime ANDed with B. So what's interesting here, we can say that we let K equal A prime. So our original equation is equal to K or K and B. Notice that we're just substituting K for A prime. And we have idempotency again, equals K B And now we substitute this back in, and that is equal to A prime B. So if A is equal to 0 and B is equal to 1, then Y will be equal to 1. Otherwise, if there's any other two input combination, it will be equal to 0. And we see this over here. And this is an example of how to use various Boolean algebra theorems to simplify a digital logic circuit.